Have they really found soft tissue in dinosaur bones? Hi, my name is Calvin Smith, and welcome to Creation Basics, where our goal is to make God's creation part of your everyday conversation. Today's topic is, have they really found soft tissue in dinosaur bones? Now, we've discussed this before, but it's such a popular topic, we keep having to revisit it. I mean, if you ask the average layperson how he, you know, or she knows that the Earth is millions or billions of years old, many of them would probably mention dinosaurs, because everybody knows they died out 65 million years ago. But we've known for a while now, for over 15 years, that there's a large elephant in the room that should give reason for all but the most committed evolutionists to question this assumption. And that prickly pachyderm is this. If dinosaurs lived over 65 million years ago, why do some dinosaur fossils still contain well-preserved soft tissues? So let's revisit the history of the evidence of what really kicked off this whole bombshell to the whole story of evolution, because surprisingly to many, evolutionists have now conceded that soft tissue has been found in what they consider dinosaur or dinosaur-era creatures now numerous times over. It's not even questioned by most informed evolutionists now. You see, what was found years ago were bone slices from a fossilized thigh bone, a femur, of a Tyrannosaurus rex found in Hell Creek Formation of Montana. And they were studied under the microscope by Dr. Mary Schweitzer. To her amazement, the bones showed what appeared to be blood vessels of the type seen in bone and marrow. And these contained what appeared to be red blood cells with nuclei typical of reptiles and birds, but not mammals. The vessels even appeared to be lined with specialized cells found in all blood vessels. And amazingly, the bone marrow contained what appeared to be flexible tissue. Now, initially, some skeptical scientists suggested that bacterial biofilms, which are just dead bacteria aggregated in slime, like what you might see on the inside of the rim of a bucket you leave outside, formed what only appeared to be blood vessels and bone cells. But then Schweitzer and her co-workers found biochemical evidence for intact fragments of the protein collagen, which is the building block of connective tissue. And this is important because collagen is a highly distinctive protein not made by bacteria. Now, originally, some evolutionists strongly criticized Schweitzer's conclusions because they were understandably reluctant to concede the existence of blood vessels, cells with nuclei, tissue elasticity, and intact protein fragments in a dinosaur bone dated at supposedly 68 million years old because it was devastating to the evolutionary story and timeline. But over time, evolutionists who've since found Schweitzer's evidence too compelling to ignore, simply conclude that there's some previously unrecognized form of fossilization that preserves cells and protein fragments over tens of millions of years. But an obvious question arose from Schweitzer's work. Is it even remotely plausible that blood vessel cells and protein fragments can exist largely intact that long? While many consider such long-term preservation of tissue and cells to be very unlikely, the problem is that no human or animal remains are known with certainty to be 68 million years old. But if creationists are right, dinosaurs died off only 3,000 to 4,000 years ago. So, would we expect the preservation of vessels, cells, and complex molecules of the type Schweitzer reports for biological tissues historically known to be 3,000 to 4,000 years old? Well, the answer is yes. For example, many studies of Egyptian mummies and other humans of this old age, confirmed by historical evidence, show all sorts of details that Schweitzer reported in her T-Rex. But see, regardless of the observable facts in front of their own eyes, the worldview paradigm conforming to the story of evolution is powerful indeed. Needless to say, no evolutionist has publicly considered the possibility that dinosaur fossils are not millions of years old. They simply take the new information and conclude there must be some mysterious way that soft tissue could last for 65 million years. After all, you can see it in the bones that are supposedly 65 million years old. So, have they really found soft tissue in dinosaur bones? Yes. And we conclude that the preservation of vessels and cells and complex molecules in dinosaurs is entirely consistent with a young Earth creationist perspective, but it is highly implausible with the evolutionist's perspective about dinosaurs that they died off millions and millions of years ago. If you're appreciating this content, visit the answersingenesis.ca website for much more. Please consider donating to the ministry, and whatever platform you're accessing this on, it likely has some combination of features that allow you to subscribe or like or share, and we'd appreciate you taking the time to do so because it's probably the best thing you can do to help us continue to do outreach. Until next time, I'm Cal Smith. Blessings to you.